Hello world, welcome to Surajology. Ever wonder how Netflix recommends awesome shows you like? Or how Facebook can auto-tag your face? Or how Google's self-driving cars work? Or how Bing can... What's that? You don't care what Bing does? It's okay, nobody does. Anyways, the answer is machine learning. Machine learning is a study of algorithms that learn from examples and experience instead of hard-coded rules. So let's say you want to build an app that can recognize an image of a specific species of flower called iris. If you decide to code this without machine learning, you'd have to write a bunch of different functions to detect all the different features of an iris flower. The problem is there are a bunch of corner cases and there's no way you could account for all of them ahead of time. Like, what if one of the leaves is partially obstructed, or a flower is a certain color that you didn't account for, or the shape is totally different than what you expected? You can't just code all that up beforehand, unless you're Jeff Dean. Just kidding, Jeff Dean can't do it, nobody can. You have to use machine learning to solve this problem. And here's the best part, it's actually super easy and you don't need to be a math person to do it. There are just four steps involved in the process. Collect data, pick the model, train the model, and test the model. We'll basically just add data to a model and it will start to find patterns in the data for us. We're gonna make this iris flower recognition app with just 7 lines of Python using 2 dope libraries, SciKit Learn and TensorFlow, which we'll import right at the start. So let's do this. The first step is to get our data. Datasets come in all different kinds of formats, PDFs, CSVs, holograms. It doesn't matter the format, we can easily parse it in our code to get the relevant details. We'll be using a well-known dataset that contains 150 samples of iris flowers. Luckily for us, this dataset comes preloaded with scikit learn, so we can just load it here. Each sample has a label, one of 3 types of iris, ptosis, virginica, or versicolor, and a set of features, sepal length, sepal width, petal length, and petal width. Because our data is labeled, the type of learning we're doing is called supervised learning. If we didn't have labels for our data, just features, then it would be called unsupervised learning. So yeah, these are good features. They're simple, independent, and informative, as all features should be. By the way, if you're ever deciding on what kind of features you should look for in a dataset, a good rule of thumb is thinking about what features you personally would need to figure out to determine whatever your goal is. So if you're trying to determine Jedi or Sith, given a dataset of lightsabers, don't pick something like weapon status as a feature. Use blade colors and curvature as your feature. So now that we have our dataset, the next step is to pick the model. To do that, you just have to calculate the multivariate equation for discriminant analysis by squaring the delta of the... Just kidding. You literally just paste in a single line of code. The real question is, how do you know which of the bajillion machine learning models to use? Well, we're trying to classify an image as either an iris flower or not an iris flower. So we know this is a classification problem. Therefore, we'll need to use a classifier. Okay, that narrows our options, but what type? Like, there are a lot of those too. My gut reaction is to use a deep neural network because it just sounds dope, you know what I mean? But there are countless others. The answer is it depends. It depends on the size of your data and your application requirements. Currently, if you have a lot of data, deep neural networks pretty much outperform every other machine learning model across a wide variety of use cases. But in our case, we only have 150 samples, so we use something simple and standard, a linear classifier. We'll set the class parameter to 3. You can also easily just switch out the model with another one and see the difference in accuracy. It's just one line of code. Like, that's all it would take to use a deep neural net to classify this if we wanted to. That way you'll know which one works best. Now that we've picked our model, it's time to train it. Training is the actual learning step. As your model iterates through the data set, it gets better and better at prediction. Since we're using a classifier, we just need to call the fit method on our object to train our model. Fit is our training algorithm. This method will input the training dataset into our model, finding patterns in the data. Boom, done. Now whenever we input a new flower from our testing dataset, it'll automatically be able to classify it as one of the 3 types of iris flower. We can see in terminal that the accuracy score for classification is pretty high. How easy was that? Just 7 lines of code and now you have your first model trained and ready to recognize flowers. You just made a learning machine. And you can use the same model to classify other things like cars and dresses and Republican candidates. Machine learning can be applied to so many different things, from fraud detection to generating paintings like Picasso. If you'd like to see more machine learning videos, please subscribe. I'm gonna release a lot of them. And for now, I've gotta go fix a runtime error. So thanks for watching.